Well, the man who's already sorted out the situation in many other cities countrywide when it comes to traffic flows, Martin Cassini, is invited by the Traffic Forum campaign group into the city to advise him on how to deal with the lengthening queues and the chaos. Martin, nice to talk to you. I think it's a couple of times you've been to Hereford now in your role. Your view of the way the traffic is managed in the city?
Generally, I find that regulation and the basic rule of the road militates against human beings acting sociably. So the kind of basic idea is to design roads for a social context rather than a traffic engineering context. If we live by equality, we just took it in turns like we do in other walks of life, it worked. Take away the traffic lights. I've seen it across the central London on two occasions while I used to live in King's Cross. You know, people say it can work on a micro scale, but it works on a macro scale as well. Wherever I've seen traffic lights out of action, and what happens, we approach carefully, we act sociably, we rediscover our humanity, we basically take it in turns. This is what happened in Portishead. We bagged over the lights. Everyone was saying it'll never work. But it worked a treat, and they haven't looked back, and the massive queues are now a distant memory.
Martin, we'll have to leave it there. Thank you for your time. He's a video producer and campaigner for traffic system reform. You might have a look at his website. It's quite interesting. Quality Streets, which will give you an idea of what he's been up to.
Without traffic lights telling us what to do, we start thinking for ourselves. Our cooperative impulses fire up and create courtesy, caution and give and take instead of competition and aggression. The immediate effect of the lights being temporarily down was a measurable increase in the road network's efficiency, resulting in less congestion and shorter queues.